What's up YouTube? Today I'm doing a video about the top 5 things that I would do differently if I was going to start all over again. And the reason I'm making a video, this style video, is basically because it's pretty much where I am right now in my life. I've started a new chapter. If you've seen my other videos, you'll understand why and where I am. And I've come to the point where I'm starting to reflect on how I'm going to move forward in my life. So I've had a month now of reflecting back on this in Bangkok, and I'm trying to figure out my next path. So I was thinking about the top 5 things I'll do all over again, and I've reflected on my business journey over the last 4, 5, 6 years. So here we go, let's get straight into it. Okay. Number 1, build a business that complements my desired lifestyle. So as you can see here in these photos, this is me about 9 years ago in Fiji. So when I was 20 years old or 21 years old, I left Italy. I went traveling on my own for a year in New Zealand. And that was straight away gave me the hook or the bug for traveling. And I've always wanted to see the world. It's always been a lifelong dream. I never saw myself living in one place forever. I would never thought about just kind of getting a 9-to-5, working the same job for 30 years in the same company, and then getting a retirement pension and seeing that was it basically, and traveling when I was older, when I had some money and I'm too old to actually enjoy it. So I'd always been passionate about traveling. I want to see what the world has got to offer. I want to meet new people. I want to have good conversations, have a good support network around me, experience different cultures, just basically be a big worldwide tourist. So that is very difficult to do when you've got a fixed location style business like I've got. Or I have still got going right now. Like here in this photo is me stuck at a desk in my business, which is great and I have a great time doing it, but it's very difficult to have a lifestyle that allows you to travel when you've got this. And I'm very lucky that I've got an amazing staff, a team. I'm very lucky that I've got an amazing group of team members that work for me that have allowed me to basically do what I do now. Granted, I've put the work in to get to this point where I am, but again, the credit due where is due is to my team members that allow me to live where I am right now. So having a fixed location means you're stuck in one place, and it makes it very difficult to take more than 30 days a year off on holiday to be able to go away and experience this. And realistically, 30 days a year, or whatever the national holidays allowances per year, doesn't allow you to be able to see the world properly. You know, you've got to go back, then you've got to make sure you've got enough money to do that. And when you're self-employed as well, that if you take time off from a physical location style business, you're going to lose money. You're not earning any money. So that's the point. That's that point. Then this phrase came to mind: work to live or live to work. So I was very much one of those people who was live to work, but in the end, it has paid off for me now. You know, it has set myself up in the position that I am, but I've changed my kind of mindset recently. And I definitely am in the mindset of work to live. I don't have any intentions or desire to work my life away like the old Alex Hormozi style lifestyle. And granted, if you want to do that, absolutely. I understand if you want to be super, super successful and you want to have these huge businesses, I do, because that's something I wanted to have at one point. You know, I thought about it, but after going through that process of building a business and going through the stresses of doing that, you know, I took a step back and reflected on actually what I genuinely wanted in my life and not what I perceived to be the kind of level of success people need to get to be able to be recognized as successful. So that's something that I had to come to terms with in myself. You know, when I was younger, I did think, right, well, I want to build a £100 million business. But going through even just the small steps of building my small business, I've realized that that is not actually what I want. I want to work to live. I want to work to be able to take time off to see my family, to see my friends, to go and experience all the things that this beautiful life has to offer, even because it's so short. So that will come into play when I decide my new career or my new project that I'm going to work on. This point, online versus physical. So when I'm going to be coming to desire to building this business around that, around when I come to build this business that complements my desired lifestyle, I'll definitely be choosing the online version. Now, the reason I do this is because I'm thinking about this is because after you weigh up all the pros and cons combined with this kind of style of life that I want to live, opting for a physical style business just doesn't make sense to me. There's no advantage to building this style business versus an online one? Because in an online world right now, and that's pretty much where the whole world is heading, the margins, the life setup, the possibilities, the growth, the scalability, they all point to working online. And as much as I am a physical style business person, which I've had experience, it doesn't mean I can't turn my hand to making an online business. All it means I have to learn again, and that's fine because it is a bit of a journey. But every single situation or every single point that I think about when I weigh up the pros and cons points to doing an online business, that because that is going to complement my desired lifestyle. So as I'm coming into this period and I've got lots of different projects going on, the way I'm going to do this is I'm going to reverse engineer my desired lifestyle and build a business around that. And that's going to be the skills. So I'm going to basically think about how many hours I want to work. Where do I want to be located in the world? How many staff members do I want working for me in this organization? What is the project going to be around? Does it complement the things that I believe in, the kind of life mottos, etc.? And I'm going to build a business around that instead of building a business and then creating a life around that business or skill set. Essentially, the skills to building a business are the same. If you're doing online one or physical, you know, the principles, sales, marketing, all those kind of things, they're all the same in essence. So I've already done this once, so it doesn't matter if I go into a different career because I know I've done this before and I'm confident in myself to be able to do that. Okay, moving on. Okay, so here's another one that's very important. Build a business that has extremely low fixed cost. So as I was growing Cosmic Campervans, one of the things that really stressed me out is the high fixed costs every single month. What does fixed cost mean for people who don't really know this kind of stuff? It basically means the costs that that are going to be involved that you have to pay every single month without fail. So that's going to be staff employee costs, as you can see here from one of my outtakes of my accounts, rent, subscriptions for certain software, etc. All the costs that you have to pay every single month, whether you make any money or you don't. So high fixed cost means high intense amounts of pressure, and that can really get people down. And it's something I went through. You know, I'm not ashamed to admit that I did go through very difficult stages in my mental strength to be able to get through this pressure, and it does wear you down. So one of the things I'll be focusing on is building a business model that has very low fixed cost and high margins. And that all, again, points to an online business because you don't have a fixed location, so you don't need to rent anywhere. You're not paying business rates on rents. You're not paying all the kind of taxes that are involved in running a physical business. And I'll definitely be running a very lean operation, because what that means is when you're running a lean operation, you can afford to take time off. You can afford to not have to worry about making huge amounts of income every single month just to pay big bills. And it comes down to that one saying I say all the time, again, that someone taught me, you know, turnover is vanity, profit is sanity. It doesn't matter if you've got £1 million turnover, if your costs and your fixed and your costs are £990,000, because you're only making £10,000 in profit. You may as well have £100,000 turnover with a 90% profit margin like an online business can have, because you're going to end up with much more money in your pocket by the end of it. So I would definitely be looking for a business model that has low numbers of staff, low fixed costs, and high margins. And this is an example here. Gross employee salary for my business at one point, £106,000. You know, for some people, that's not going to be a lot of money. It's probably piss in the wind. But to be honest, for me, that was a lot of money when I was running my small business, trying to grow it. It's money I had to find every single month, whether I got the work in or not. I had to pay that kind of money out every single other thing that I had to pay for. So one thing I would do again is make sure I don't have a large number of staff members. I really want to build a very, very lean operation, something that allows me to make very good profit margins, because a large number of staff members equals stress. And that has been 100% one of the things I've realized, because until you've done this, you won't realize this point. And a lot of staff members might see this video and, you know, I'm working for someone. Yes, it is stressful running a business and having staff members for you. Until you've actually done it yourself, you will never understand this point. Here's another one. This is really important. I'm going to take my mental and physical health more seriously. So here's a couple of contexts. This is back in COVID, March 2020 or so. Again here, here's me completely fast. I'll just go back to this video. So this is me pretty much about to pass out. I did a 10-minute HIIT workout, Joe Wicks HIIT workout from YouTube, and I just couldn't even do the whole workout. I never ever went to the gym. I never ate healthy. I was just out of shape. I didn't think about things I was eating. You can see it in my face here. Just got no definition or anything like that. I'm just got bags around my eyes. And I never took my health seriously. I wasn't exercising regularly. This is me. One of the photos my girlfriend used to take of me regularly, constantly asleep. When I got home from work, I would just pretty much pass out for 2 hours on the sofa because I just had no energy left. I was dealing with so much stress at work and not taking care of myself mentally and physically that I just didn't have the energy to keep going. As soon as I got home, I'd just sit on the sofa and there would be no stopping me falling asleep. It was very difficult. And here's a caption from my Instagram. You know, I've actually got to a point where I'm doing really well. I'm barely breaking a smile. And my own thing is there's a rare smile on my face while I'm at work or just at all. And that just sums it up. That's basically the mindset and the situation I was in. I had a clouded mind and thoughts because I didn't exercise every single day. So I couldn't expel that kind of anger inside or that kind of cloud, the brain fog that was in my mind. I just basically woke up. There's always complicated things going off all the time. I don't even know how I managed to get where I am right now when I look back at it. I really don't know how I managed to do what I've done in the conditions that I left my mental and physical state in. You know, I do that. One thing and one of my biggest regrets about running my business, you know, is I was angry all the time. I was constantly angry, snapping at family members and friends. The pressure I was under running this business is just wasn't worth it sometimes. It really wasn't. It really wasn't worth it. And it's very hard for people to understand that unless they've done that. And I don't expect people to deal with the stuff I put them through, you know. And you have to, I do reflect back on those times and the things I've said and the things I've done. You know, it is hard to accept the things I have done. But unfortunately, it's just that's the pressure. That's what the pressure was doing to me. And I won't be going back to doing that again. I'm in the gym every single day here. I'm looking at myself on the camera. I'm in a way better stage, way better position right now. I can see it in my own eyes. You know, I look at photos and I look back at myself. Is that me? Like, is that actually how I used to look? Because I was just so stressed all the time and I just didn't have time to think about anything else because I was just constantly thinking about growing the business and putting out fires and dealing with staff members and dealing with customers. So one of my main goals now is not just to make as much money as possible like it was then, it's to basically take care of my mental and physical health. And when things, if I'm not, one of the rules I'm doing now is if I don't enjoy doing something, I'm not going to do it. I tried to take a video earlier with a camera talking about subjects I didn't even, because I thought it's going to get some views on YouTube, and I just couldn't do it. I'm not going to do a task or a project that I just don't believe in, that's not going to make me happy. That's definitely one of my rules for the next thing. Okay, here is another one. I'm going to locate myself in a country that is friendly to young entrepreneurs. And I'm pretty much there now. I'm here in Bangkok. And the reason I've done this is the UK is a failed society, for sure, 100%. One of the things I went through when I was building my business here in the back in the UK is like, no one would take me seriously. No one would take me seriously whenever I wanted to do something. I tried to get insurance for a trade policy, for example, for my business. As soon as they heard I was 23 or 24 years old, it was literally impossible to get an insurance policy on my business. I just had to deal with no insurance for 2 years. There was nothing I could do. No, not a single person in the whole entire UK would insure me. I couldn't find capital very easy. I had to go through loads of different means to get this capital in the end to start my business. So it was very difficult. Yeah, so it was hard to start the business in the first place because there's not really that much support out there in the UK for guys like me trying to start a business at 23 years old. So that brings me to UK versus Dubai versus Bangkok. Well, here's me in Dubai, Alex, Wakar, and Jack. two amazing guys I met in Dubai when we did a podcast networking with Jack out there. Here's me and Jack and Tom Spark, another awesome guy I met through the New Elite. And the reason I had the opportunity to even think about moving to Dubai is that it's very easy to move there as a UK expat. Very friendly working conditions in terms of opening a business is very simple. And I did think about it, to be honest, but I also had the opportunity of coming here to Bangkok. Now, my reasons for choosing Bangkok over Dubai is that personally, I like the freedom that Thailand provides. Whilst Dubai is an amazing place, it is kind of full of fake people. Not pointing at this, obviously. It's full of fake people. And you feel like someone's always watching over your shoulder. I like the safety aspect of it, don't get me wrong, but you do feel like someone's looking over your shoulder a lot. Whereas you don't feel like that in Thailand. I get a lot of freedom here, and it's much more liberating than Dubai. But don't get me wrong, I absolutely love Dubai for business opportunities, networking opportunities. The weather is good when it's not too hot, and the quality of the beach clubs like this is great. So yeah, it's great for going there for 4 or 5 days a week, like I'm going to be doing next week. You can fly from Bangkok to Dubai in six hours, very simple. So yeah, that's one of the reasons that I chose Bangkok over the others. I won't be going back to the UK at all because the whole environment is just shit. There's so much tax, there's so many different rules and regulations. All I get is brown envelopes through the fucking letterbox from the government wanting this, that, and other from me. And I'm sick of it, had enough of it. Not going back to that shit all ever again. Anyway, networking opportunities I've just mentioned. When you're in these countries, there's just so many more opportunities to meet people that are on the same journey as you. And that's something that's gonna help me on my next journey, having those people around me. Like this, you're the sum of the five people you spend time with. That's really important. You know, if you just hang around with losers all the time, you're going to become a loser. If you hang around with people who are in shape, you're going to get in shape. You know, I'm hanging around with all the guys in the New Elite who are in shape, and I'm getting myself into shape now. It just happens. It's just natural. So that's it. You're some of the five people you spend the time with here in Bangkok and Dubai and Thailand in general. There's many more people who are on the same online journey. They're doing their own thing. They're there to support you. You don't get that in the UK. That's why I wouldn't do that in the future. I wouldn't move to a country that doesn't allow growth. Gone past one. Okay, final slide. Get help from a mentor sooner. So basically, how much is it costing you not knowing the road ahead? This is me about 3 years ago, stuck with a LED lamp on my head, fitting roofs, in work gear, picking phone calls up, doing sales, doing emails, organizing this, organizing that. I'm all over the place. And what it took is someone to come into my business and say, what are you doing? You know, you're making all this money, but you're doing everything yourself. You could just literally take a step back, earn X amount less, but get so much more time back. And that's what it took. It took someone else to tell me that because I didn't know that. So how much is it costing you not knowing that path ahead of you? And I had to be told that as well. You know, it's an experience. When you're building a business, you learn these things as you go along. But if you can get a mentor that can speed up that process, it's going to accelerate your growth so much quicker. And that's going to earn you money in the long run. I know it sounds like you're going to spend a lot of money at the start when you get a mentor. But in the time scale, it's going to earn you so much more money. If you think about it, if you actually think about it logically. Sometimes some people can see things clearer than you can in your own head, in your own business. Because like in this position here, because I was so stuck in the workshop, so stuck in all these crazy things going on, because at this point, my head was just jumbled. If you try to ask me a question, after 5 minutes, I forget. I was just all over the place. So if you could get a fresh pair of eyes to come in and look at your business or look at the problems that you're facing, because they've got a clearer mind and they've not got all these thoughts going on in the head, they're going to think of solutions quicker than you can. And that's what happened for me. That's exactly what happened for me. You know, that's how I ended up with Matt. My mentor told me I was doing too much of all these sales calls and working on the vans, etc. I needed to get someone in the office. And that's how Matt came and worked for me. Absolute amazing lad. Did an amazing job for me while he worked for me. And it made the business completely different. And it gave me the opportunity to sit back and start to actually pull the strings to grow the business like I should be doing, which is what I was good at. I'm not great at doing all the conversion work, but I'm great at pulling the strings and figuring out how to grow the business. But I just didn't have time because I was always doing this stuff. So my growth was just stagnating like that until it took someone to take a good, clear look at it and say, this is what you need to do. And that's another thing as well. Don't get stuck in your old ways. Having a mentor will give you that opportunity to highlight the things that you're doing wrong, possibly. And because you're kind of, you've done things the same way all the time, you'll probably be resistant to doing it. But if you listen to that person, tell you how to do it in a better way, and put that into action, then you'll end up where I was, behind the desk instead of here. You know, and that's always good. And the final point, and I guess this is something I've always had to deal with as well, you're not always right. There's been many times in my business when I've been wrong. And as a business owner, it's very easy to get caught up in the ego of your own ego, thinking that you're always right because you're the boss. You're not. You have to understand that sometimes other people are right and they might have better ideas than you. And I've learned that through my career so far. I often take advice from people and I try very much to reflect on the things that I say and the things that I do and try to see it from other people's view. So having a mentor will help you do that. They'll be able to say that you're in the wrong in this situation. Like I've been many times with my staff members or certain situations, customers, for example, certain business deals, negotiations, having someone else have a look at that situation for you can help you massively and help you avoid stepping on a landmine in the future. Okay. Final point, final slide. Right, guys, I hope you've enjoyed this video. I've tried very briefly to be able to give you an insight into what's going on in my head right now with this stuff. But if you could please go follow my socials, guys, drop me a subscribe on this YouTube, drop me a like on the video. It really helps me out. Drop me a comment if you like this kind of content. And again, you can go follow my daily life on Instagram. That's where I put all my content. And final point, going back onto this mentor point before, if you have a small business and you want some advice from someone like myself to help you out, if you're thinking about trying to set processes that allow you to remove yourself from the daily life of your business and be able to move away and travel to Thailand, drop me a message on my Instagram. I'm opening 3 spots for mentoring opportunities. I only want to work with certain clients, so please drop me a message with what you're doing, where you are in your business, and if that's something I can help with, then I'll reach back out to you. Anyway, I hope you've enjoyed this video. See you on the next one. It will be a vlog video next time. Thank you very much, guys.